Good evening, everyone. How's it going? Welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing all right. Akira, thank you very much, man. Thank you for the follow as well, by the way. But yeah, flashy new intro screen. 2 minute timer that I can turn on when I'm actually ready to like sit down at the desk and go. The schedule information, I can customize that. So like the times and stuff are just a text box, so if the schedule changes down the line, I can just update that as we need to. It's pretty cool. The only thing I actually added to this was the countdown timer and the now playing current music track at the bottom. But I think it's pretty cool. And yeah, this one's similar. Like I added the now playing, all of the social media stuff at the bottom. That was like, essentially, this is Stream Elements free overlay pack, like scene pack thing. So I downloaded this. So the whole thing was pre-built. The scenes are insane. Like when I made a scene on the old setup, I had maybe like 6 or 7 parts to it. These are insane. Yeah, there's so many components to these scenes, it's unreal. But yeah, it's cool. Like I just had to put in my own details at the bottom. I've added the time and the now playing to this bit, but you've got a chat box over there. There's new alerts that pop up as well. I don't know if you saw it when you hit the follow button. And yeah, it flips as well. So we've got the intro, which is this one, and then the outro is exactly the same kind of idea, but it just flips it over, which is kind of cool. We've got a break scene now as well. This one here, got your current time, you've got the chat on there. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I like it. It's quite nice because it's simple compared to like the circuit board look we went for before. But it's still interesting. Like it's not just a black and white screen, you know. It's got some interest in it, and yeah, I just think the schedule stuff works really well. I like it. It's had positive feedback so far from the people who've seen it. So I'll take that as a win. What up, Slade? How's it going? I was looking at the radio. Well, I'm here. 9 p.m. It's right here. Look, on the right hand side of your screen. Right there. No excuse. There's even a thing underneath the video as well, if you're on PC. Underneath the video, there's a whole schedule panel that gives you a 2-second countdown of when I go live. It's no excuse. The thought is appreciated, Slade. Honestly, thank you very much. I'm guessing I was like 15 minutes out. But yeah, I really like this overlay. I spent about 2-3 hours like downloading everything and then customizing it and tweaking it slightly. And Anthem, 79 gig. Ouch. Let me just buy a new hard drive to put that on there. Don't know what my storage is looking like at the minute, but I know it's not much. What have I got? 28 gig on my SSD, 48 gig on my first drive, 105 gig on my 2 terabyte drive, and then 40 gig on my backup drive. So yeah, the only one I could put that on is my 2 terabyte drive, and I'm pretty sure that's like the lowest performance drive that I've got. Oh well. Okay, cool. The stream core bot's kind of readjusted to me existing. Quite nice. It wasn't doing it for a little while. I think because I had to change my Twitch password and that messed around with some of my login access and stuff. But I got back into the habit of manually posting it. But it seems to have done it in mine and in your Discord, Slade, so that's cool. Okay, plan for tonight. We're gonna play some Dead Cells. I reset my save. So we're starting from, like, we haven't cleared it on this save. I have done a few, like, playthrough attempts and unlocked a few bits. Damn it. What was that track that was on when we actually hit the button? Can't remember what it was now. Don't even remember who it was. It was that one. Just that was cool. I want that one on again later. But yeah, how's everyone doing? Thank you for coming and hanging out. Can we try that again, maybe? This is on Origin 2. That's. That's good to know. Would have been good to know yesterday. But hey ho. Yeah, how you all doing? Thank you for coming and hanging out. / roll. What was that for? Don't want any of these. That one's better. Jeebus. Dude, I did see that message. Thank you very much. I will check that out after the stream probably, and I will let you know. That one. Okay, let's do this. Toxic sewer run. Slow. You seem to understand what I'm saying. I lost a rune. I mean, my rune. You see, I'm a little stuck. I need my rune, you see. Wouldn't mind finding it for me, would you? Sure thing. Oh, thank you. It's somewhere around here in these sewers on your side of these bars. Bring it back to me quick. I need to unlock the ability to choose a melee weapon at the start of the game, rather than having to use this busted sword. Is my hard drive Saturn? No. No, I've never... It's one of the things I've always meant to kind of investigate, but never actually got around to doing. I've never looked at how to set up, slash the benefits of, slash whether my stuff is compatible with going into a... Oh, no, wait, sorry, yeah. Sorry, I was thinking RAID. Yes, my hard drive is Saturn. I was about to go on a rant about RAID and that kind of thing. I was like, yeah, I have no idea on RAID. But that's not what you asked. Got an SSD SATA for my old PC to give Sam. Even sat in the box for a few months. I mean, if it's feeling a bit left out and wants a new home, just saying. Something to do with that bit. Ow! I was behind you. And shenanigans on that. Take that just because we have nothing else anyway. It is quite useful. Oh, excuse me. So, you guys know how I felt awful about missing the Thursday stream last week and like lugging the PlayStation down to London with me and packing the hotel TV and all that kind of fun stuff. Well, I'm going to London again. I'm going to London again on Thursday. Which means I'm going to miss another Thursday stream. I'm not going to take the PlayStation with me again this time. I'm just going down for the one night. It's a lot of extra weight and hassle setting the PlayStation up for one night. Two nights I could justify. Yeah, one night it's a bit much. That being said, I'm probably going to try and do a stream from my phone, even if it's just like half an hour sat on my phone. Doing an IRL thing. You know, just getting something. But yeah. So that's the plan. Doosh. until you've stumbled through a rift. Oh, that was harsh. Oh, we got it. Can you guys hear me, all right? I think the mic's all right. No. Audio's good, image 10x10, nice. Nope. Can't go that way yet, we need the spider climb. Right, we don't want to go ramparts, we want to go... the other way. There we go. My rune is just a little bit further on. Got him. Skadoosh. What are you rubbing at anyway? Oh, that's some good coffee. Okay, let's go. There's no one there. Right. So does that mean, I think it does, the only way I can go is ramparts. So I think this bit here. Is, I need the spider climb for it. But on the flip side of that is, I need to go through this gate here, I think. To get to where I need to go for the spider climb. So I think I've just got unlucky on the map. A bit jealous, waiting for Sammy to come out my brew, incapable of doing my own, obviously. I wasn't gonna say it. Oh, we just got in for the time as well, even with getting the rune. Yes. Enemies then we freeze and down attack smashes the ground. Down attack burns the ground even, not smashes the ground. We need to get Crow's Foot as well. That's a good one. But first, that one. What do we need? One more item for that. We've got 47 cells. So we could just unlock one of these. I think we're going to throw it towards Crow's Foot. Because I use that every time. Now we only need three more. Victims burn when they die. Nice. Damage to bleed. And that one inflicts bleeding. That's not a bad combo, actually. We'll go with that. Let's go combo. Oosh. Ram the man part. Just realized there's no timestamp on my Twitch chat. Wait a second. There we go. That's better. Oops. Oh, you blocked. All the shenanigans right there. Any hope of a big kill combo? Oh, wow. Oh, I need to get the stamp room at some point. Nope. That was disappointing for all that. That was a long way back. Oh. It's annoying because other than those shield guys, I've been clearing everything pretty well. It's those ones that seem to be giving me grief today. Just mildly infuriating. That one. Blah 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 blah. Can't get down there yet. Oh my god. That got interesting. Fireballs right now.
Move.
That was close. I almost had the lift fall on my head. What was it doing? Get random melee weapon. Yeah, that'll work. We're gonna go crow's foot. So need one more point in red, and then we're just gonna dump everything in purple. Got the boss. Oh. Let's go. Get out of it. Oh, damn it. That could have gone a lot better. What have we got there? Oh, hello, Pan. We are going to take that. I like the Pan. We are not going to take that. We are going to take that. Yeah, that boss could have gone a lot better. Oh, 24 seconds over the timer. I'm just going to put everything into random melee weapon now until we get that unlocked. Actually, what's the Pan got? Crits do 20%. Reforge that one. Victims emit toxic cloud when they die. That's more like it. And launches a grenade. I get up there. Just, I love the sound effects on the Pan. So satisfying. Actually mean to launch that then. From one trap to another. No. I feel like there's something missing here. Or that I'm missing something there. Would be a better way of saying that. that's everything in there. Did see there was a... Yeah, there's a scroll over here. I'll start tricking into purple now. Hey, Thuns, how's it going? Welcome back. Of bleeding spreads it to other enemies nearby. It's quite useful with a tool that inflicts bleeding. Not so useful for bosses though. Does do more damage. Yeah, screw it, we'll go with it. All of the bleed effect. Damn. Let's go this way. Yeah, how's it going, Thuns? Doing all right? Awesome stuff. I'm not doing too bad, thank you. Work's still in the air. I have no idea what's happening with work. Keep chasing my boss about it, and he's trying. He's chasing his boss. But yeah, I don't know what's happening, which is wonderful. I've been told that no matter what, they will give me, like, worst case, if I'm not being kept on, they will give me 4 weeks' notice. So, the reason that's a good thing is my contract, as I signed it in August last year, is due to run out in 2 weeks' time, and I haven't heard anything. But the fact that they have to give me 4 weeks' notice means I've, you know, I've at least got 4 weeks, which is good. But it would still be nice to know. What's going on? Burn when they die, launches grenades. That all works. That'll play. He's a waffle. Love you too, Slade. But yeah, essentially, at the moment, I don't know if I'm being kept on. My contract is due to run out in 2 weeks. I haven't heard anything. My manager and his manager are trying to get me to be kept on full time, which would be ideal. But we need like HR, who are based in the States, to sign it off and basically say, yes, we have the budget to do this. Like I say, my manager and his manager think it would be a great idea. The workload is there, so it makes sense for me to do it from their point of view. If I go full time, I can get more involved in other aspects of the business and the teamwork that I haven't been able to get involved in so far. So everything points to it being a good idea for everybody involved. But HR haven't signed it off. So I'm currently waiting in limbo to find out if I'm being kept on, if I'm being kept on part-time, or if I'm being kept on full-time. And yeah, as it is, I have no idea. So, but like I say, my management team think, well, my management team would be surprised if I don't get kept on. But, like I say, my contract was only due to run for another 2 weeks. And then I was going to be, like, that's the end of my contract. However, I have been informed that despite that being the case, they still have to give me 4 weeks notice, whatever happens. So if it gets to the 17th of February and my contract says I'm due to run out on the 18th of February, they would still have to give me 4 weeks notice rather than saying, right, you're being let go tomorrow. No, to be honest, I don't think they're dragging it out because it's good or bad news. That I think they're dragging it out because, like, obviously, I'm in the UK. The team that I work in is split across the UK and the US. My manager is in the UK. His manager is in the States. And then HR is in the States. And the biggest impact that has is that me and my manager can have a chat during the day. Which is fine. But then we have to kind of wait for the time difference to catch up to talk to the guys in the States. Oh yeah, Kira, I've got that stuff sorted out. That's fine. Yeah, Thuns, I mean, it's, at the minute, it's just lots of kind of chasing back and forth. Like, we'll see what happens. Like, it's being chased. Like, that's kind of where I'm at. Like I say, I've got that reassurance now that no matter what happens, I need to work 4 weeks notice. Like, which I thought would be the case, but I wasn't 100% sure. Now that I am, that's a bit of a sigh of relief, I guess. Slade, yes, I'm using a pan. It's actually really good. can't go that way yet. Darkness too long. Yeah, so I'm heading down there again on Thursday. Let's see if anything's come up from then. Nice. It's not the best melee weapon, but it's better than the basic sword you get normally to start out with. Get good. Oh yeah, there is that. A shiny pebble. So we've got a few people in there at the minute, haven't we? A few of you guys around. Which is appreciated, thank you very much. But the reason I ask is I should probably tell you guys about the dare jar that is advertised in the stream title. Really? Let's go this way. What is the dare jar reference about? So, I don't know if you guys have seen, but if you look at the Discord server, there is a shiny new channel in the general tab on the left-hand side. Conveniently titled Dare Jar. So yeah, an idea that I had, this links to the fundraiser that we're doing this year. An idea that Claire had was to do a dare jar system. So you guys can go into that dare jar channel in the Discord server. And if you're not in the Discord server, now would be a great time to join it. Day to put your hand into the jar and face the wonders the jar holds. That would be a nice dare. I could quite happily do that one. Seriously, Hatbot, you don't type it for like 55 minutes and the moment I put the command in you double it. Fine, whatever. Yeah, so we're gonna set up a dare jar to do with the fundraiser. So you guys can go into the channel and you can write down 1, 2, 10 dares that you would be interested in seeing me do on stream. They have to be within Twitch TOS because you don't want to lose the channel. And ideally be something I can either do live on stream or that would be easy-ish to like record and then upload to Twitch and to YouTube down the line. Ideally not ending up with me dead would be a huge bonus. I hope that kind of falls within the TOS, but you know, it's Twitch. And then the way it will work is I've got a few people who will be kind of admining and moderating the dares. So not every dare will be, potentially not every dare would be accepted, but the ones that are will get written down on post-it notes, and I will have a physical jar at my stream desk that when we hit certain thresholds for donations, I'll draw from. Now I'm not going to be able to see the dare jar channel. Obviously, being like the admin owner of the Discord server, I could look at it, but I've muted it, so I'm not going to get any alerts for when people write in there. And I'm going to resist temptation as much as I possibly can. But yeah, that's the general idea. So I wanted to make it accessible, I guess, but at the same time, you know, it is part of the fundraiser, and I want to try and get as much money as we can for special effect over the course of the year. So to start with, I'll draw a dare every £100 that we as a community raise for special effect. Now, as a reminder, the way the fundraiser works, every time we get a payout, half of the payout will go to the fundraising, the Just Giving page, or you can just go to the Just Giving page and donate yourself. Maybe don't donate yourself, but you can make a donation independently. I'm not sure they'll take you, Akira. Sorry. But yeah, so every £100 that we raise, I'll draw a dare. And we'll see how that goes. I might raise it, I might lower it, but for now, every £100. You know, we've got the whole year to try and raise as much as we can. I've set like a £2,000, overall goal for the year, which might be ambitious, but we'll see. Just put 2 6F1s in there. Well, now I want to look. Day to paint a disco ball texture on your head and wear a disco outfit during one stream. Day to have a disco ball hat and beard filled with glitter on stream while you dance to Disco Inferno. See, this kind of thing. Put it in the Discord channel. I don't know if you guys saw yesterday, but Claire is now in the Discord server. She is going to be one of the ones moderating it. You know, mostly to make sure that it will either be A, hilarious enough to do, or B, safe enough to do. That's Marlo. I mean, the thing is, like, obviously the whole point of this, you know, it's part of the fundraiser. I'm trying to think of ways to encourage people to get in on the fundraiser. And if doing silly things like that will encourage people to get in on the fundraiser, then I'm all for it. You know, it wouldn't be the first time I've made a tit out of myself on stream. It almost definitely won't be the last. But if we can do this for a good cause, and you know, try and get people to put some donations in and build towards the fundraiser, then I'm all for it. And to be honest, I'd rather stuff like that than, you know, the horrendous things that could come up in a Dare Jar channel. So you keep throwing those ones in there. I'm all good for that. But yeah, like I say, there's the potential that not every dare you put in will get written down and put in the jar. There's obviously the potential that your dare goes in the jar but doesn't get pulled, because it'll just be a random, you know, blind draw of folded up post-it notes. So, but yeah, I want to see something fun. I've got some like set donation incentives as well, I guess. I need to finalize them. I've got like a Google spreadsheet that I'm adding to. But yeah, I want to get those finalized, and then I'll share it into the Discord and make a command for for the chat and stuff as well, so you guys can see it. But yeah, the Dare Jar is one of them. That's just a recurring one for every £100. I can tell you that there is a donation incentive to dye my beard Twitch purple, which is why the beard is growing back slightly. So yeah, that's a donation goal. I'm going to regret it, but there will be a donation goal, or maybe two, depending how painful it is, for me to wax my legs on stream. And I'm sure Claire will find that hilariously entertaining to do on stream. Yeah, there's some interesting ones on there. So keep that in mind. Don't forget about the fundraiser. Like I said, it's running all year. The Dare Jar exists. The channel's been there since the start of January, but I haven't finalized how I was going to make it work. Yeah, it was just like a locked channel that you guys couldn't see. But yeah, that is now live. It's there. Add to it. Get your dare suggestions in. Like I say, there's one or two people that will be moderating it. And once they're deemed to be appropriate, I guess, or safe or whatever, then we'll get those written down and I'll have a physical jar here with them in that we can keep an eye on the whole time, so the threat is always there. And then yeah, every time we hit £100 raised for the fundraiser, we'll draw a dare. One thing I need to see actually is if I can get a tracker or something for the fundraiser on stream. Just so that, like, there's an obvious, you know, permanent tracker available. I wonder if I can do that. Donation ticker? No. Donation goal? I think the problem is, like, the donation goal, that's just going to be, like, a manual one that I set up. I don't think that's going to track a Just Giving one. No, it's not. Wonder if it's the kind of thing I should probably sort out off stream, but you know what, I'm like, window capture, that one, add new source. Add source, specific window, that one, window title must match, done. It's promising that you're not picking that up as a source. That's wonderful. I mean, the alerts and stuff go off on stream anyway, so like it will pop up if someone donates towards it or anything like that. But it's just, I was trying to get it. So that there was a permanent tracker kind of thing. Yeah, it's not gonna do it. It's kind of frustrating. Unless I do it like this, which isn't ideal. See, the only way I can think to do it would be something like this. I guess we can do it like that. But that'll only work as long as I don't cover that tab up. There we go. I'll leave it like that for now. It's not ideal, but it'll do the job. They're just getting better and better. I want to look now. I mean, if anyone happens to know of like a Just Giving compatible, I don't know, donation tracker fundraiser thing that'll work as like a browser source or something, might do some Googling either like after stream quickly or over the weekend, see if I can find something. Because the problem is, like, that tracker there, it's not ideal anyway. It'll disappear as soon as I close the window down. It's just capturing off the monitor, it's not. Not ideal in any way, shape, or form. Ow, that hurt a lot. What about for bed? Thanks for Akira, thank you so much for swinging by. It's appreciated. Thank you for the other thing as well. Yeah, I'll check that later and I'll let you know. I'll let you know tomorrow. Or something. But yeah, have a good one, man. Over here. Did you get it? Excellent, now give it to me.
No.
I love how he just throws in the middle finger. Let's go purple. Can't grab that yet. Solid before it was broke down. Keep this door locked at all costs. The rats get out, we'll spread the malaise. I kinda like rats. Prisoner 236. This is going funny. Slade, stop it. Well, it doesn't look contaminated. How did the prisoner end up here? Another failed escape attempt. Nice. You? 1% of HP recovered per attack, plus 100% damage take. Okay. Yeah, why not? Need the grenades. Still can't get down there, which is annoying. Let's go red. How have we only got three? Woo! So yeah, we can't get to the Corrupted Prison because we haven't got the spider climb yet. Go down there, see what's to the right. Can't get up that one. Yeah, it's just that way. I'm actually pumped to see one of our dares. The What Is Love meme and the Disco Inferno one. Wait, what? This was a mistake. I'm taking it back. You guys clearly can't be trusted. It was a terrible idea. Thank you. I need to make a clip. If you have to do one of those, Claire has to watch and have fun too. And I need to make a clip. Well, yeah, the clips will be almost guaranteed, won't they? Let's face it. What we got? 40 seconds. Get up. Crawl one actually. What else do we need? Frenzy could be useful. Health regen. We could just go for flask and reserves. I think we're gonna do those actually. Love to see your face of disappointment and losing faith at the same time. It's fine. I don't know how to give this one a go. I've never had this one. But then do we lose the bleeding? Yeah, screw it, let's give it a go. That's a bit better. Damage to poison target. Getting close to 1,000 followers. Nice, dude. Right, before we go to ramparts, I should just nip the loo quickly. I will be right back. Don't go anywhere unless it's to Twitter to tell people that you're here. Click on the click to tweet link. One click to open it, one click to post. Job done. Let people know you're here. I'll be right back. Completely forgot to use my break scene then. Smart of me. Okay. Oh no, I've lost a subscriber point. Who was it? Oh. Holy crap! It's not even that game and it scared the crap out of me. Dude, what are you doing? Alright, let's pop you up there then. Slade. Dude, you are far too kind. I was headed to bed. Okay. Drago, Bianca, Scum, Empty Wallet, and Jarog, you are now all subbed, thanks to Slade. Slade, thank you so much. I completely forgot I'd changed the alert as well. Which made that even more terrifying when it went up. Yeah, it scared the crap out of me. I changed the alerts for Tarkov. Because, you know, it would have been like perfect alerts for Tarkov. But then we've kind of diverted away from Tarkov. But I haven't changed the alert sounds. Still going to bed. I mean, just fell asleep in Wild Classic with auto run enabled and ended up drowning. Alright, Jared. Thank you very much for swinging by. It's appreciated. All the love. I'll catch you later. I haven't actually used this new trap yet either, the crusher one. Maybe do that at some point. Yeah, Slade, thank you very much for dropping that sub bomb. It's appreciated. Oh. stayed with the host as well. Dude, you're far too kind. Hey, you were there. There's water running through my cell. I think something in the water touched my leg. Help! Okay, so can't actually do anything to help. Go. Let me in. What is going on this run? You can't get it today. Another trap. Oh, it is. I'm gonna go for that one. I like that trap. Now we'll go back to this one. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Not a fan of the crusher trap. Yeah, that floor could have gone better. Swap those over. Trying to dodge through that trap is a nightmare. All of the bleed. I have never played Hollow Knight. It's one that's on the list though. Same as Salt and Sanctuary. That's another one I never checked out. Really wants me to go for that. Chris, how's it going, man? Have I? problem is, because of the way they've changed it. How do I...
Chicken game?
Right. Nope. Yeah, it's because they've changed it, haven't they? I mean, they changed it a while ago. That's my collections. Games. Friends. Yeah, it's not showing up in my library. And I haven't been here in years. I know, right? How the hell are you doing? I'm just gonna burn it. Screw it. Yeah, I mean, I'm not seeing, like, any of the shared library stuff. Not just yours. Merch in your school in CSGO. That's fair enough. I've just ruined the setup that I had by trying to improve on it. Yeah, as long as you're enjoying it, Chris, that's all that matters. Big one of that. Seriously? Oh, this isn't going well. This really isn't going well. When I was 11 and now I'm 18. Holy crap. Way to make me feel old. Dude, thank you for sticking around, man. 7 years you've been part of the channel. Awesome. Well, so now I'll give you my account for once, so you can log into it on your rig, and it should be there. Yeah, I mean, I'm almost certain we've done it. Like, I remember setting it up. It just, it isn't showing. Like I say, there's another account that, in fact, two other accounts that I should have access to, but the games just aren't showing up. I don't know if they're just, like, stashed away somewhere since Steam did its big library update a while ago. Like, changed the look of everything. I need to toggle a setting somewhere, maybe. Yeah, I'm not seeing them on my gameplay. I might go for this one actually. Kind of shame, lame, you can't just share your library without having the other person logging into account. Yeah, it is a bit of a pain. See if this one goes a bit better. TD picks games are always got egg, exactly. The thing is, as I say, you know, when the sub alert went off, I changed the alerts to fit with us playing Tarkov. Yeah, we kind of made a decision to move away from Tarkov and like the big action games. Mostly from the point of view, it's so hard to keep up with the community chat in a game like Tarkov. Because like playing something like this or FTL or Isaac, that kind of thing that we've been playing since we started streaming, you know, built the channel up on, I can do a room and then I can check the chat, and I can do a room and I can check the chat, and it's so much easier. Whereas a game like Tarkov, you know, that's potentially 30, 40 minutes where you have to just be zeroed in on the game. Which isn't as bad if you've got a huge chat and like everyone's kind of chatting amongst themselves and interacting with each other. But for me, when I've only got like 3 or 4 people for the most part, you know, I kind of have to encourage chat every now and then to start talking again. It's a lot harder to play a game like Tarkov. But yeah, so like we're getting into Dead Cells. I'm looking at playing Isaac and FTL again. Maybe even Sword of the Stars, The Pit. Chris, but I don't know if you remember that one. That's one we played a long time ago. We never actually got into finish him, but that's another great one for just doing a bit and checking. When you go into your stream Steam library, you can click on Games on that big button and click on Show Games by Category. games on the drop down. Untick group by collection. No, I've got I've got nothing ticked on the filters. Games is selected in the drop-down box. Recent activity is unmarked, and only ready to play games is unmarked. I'll have a proper look at that later. But yeah, I've got nothing showing up. Like I said, there's yours and there's like two other accounts that I have been given like the family access to, and none of them are showing up. I've got 30 kills. We've missed the 2 minute mark, but we've got 31 kills, so we should get the other secret room, or locked room, sorry. Yeah, there we go. Yes. Do you ever play Escapist or Rimworld? I haven't. Heard of both of them, but never checked them out. Broadsword, nice. I'm gonna get rid of the throwing knife like the first opportunity I get. I'm gonna go crossbow. Sad that both Magisite and Pixel Piracy got left behind by the devs. Pixel Piracy rings a bell. I think I might have actually checked that one out. Sounds familiar. Oh, chair is so squeaky. Question for everyone in the channel. Has anyone got or had experience of Secret Labs chairs? I'm in the market for a new chair. I don't know how, like, when it's gonna happen, because they're expensive. but the ones I'm eyeing up are the secret lab chairs. They look really cool. They're the cheapest that I've seen of, like, the gaming chairs. But they also have, like, really, really good reviews. Like, 4.9 out of 5 out of 5,000 reviews, kind of really good. So they seem like if I'm going to spend that kind of money, that's where to go. Got a normal office chair. See, that's what I've got at the minute, but like, it's done well, but it's definitely not ideal anymore. All the padding's gone, and it's creaking, and it's got no like back support whatsoever. Kind of eyeing up getting a new one. Yeah, the Secret Lab ones, like I say, they're really well reviewed. But they're still like 300 quid. Suspected infection. Yeah, well, this is kind of it, Crisp. It's like, obviously, it's not just for the stream as well. Like, my job at the moment, and this is part of it, like, I want to see if I'm keeping this job before I invest in a good office chair. But my job is working from home, and it's at the computer all day. So, on a work day, you know, I'm spending 8-9 hours sat in this chair. And then when I'm streaming, or, you know, if I'm gaming, then that's more time that I'm sat in this chair. So I'm kind of waiting to see what's going on with my job. Because if I'm keeping my job, then it's definitely worth investing that amount of money into a good office chair. I don't know if you can hear it creaking. I don't think you can. I don't think the mic's picking up. Okay. What do you work as? So I work as part of like an installation and maintenance team for market research companies. But yeah, a lot of the work I do is remote, so I can work from home. And yeah, I just like log into PCs. I'll phone up the facility wherever they are. We've got stuff in the UK, in Europe, Asia, America. I'll phone them up and coordinate with them to do like an audio check on the room. We'll test the video and we'll test the microphones. Make sure it's all working properly. But I can do all that remotely. So I can, you know, I'll be sat here. And yeah, you know, have the laptop on, connect to everything, but it means I'm sat in this chair. And it's not as bad when I'm just streaming for like 2 or 3 hours, but yeah, now I've started, I've been doing it for 5 months, and yeah, I've definitely noticed, like, I've probably got 2 pillows behind my back to try and give it some form of padding and some form of shape to help with my back. But yeah, it's definitely not ideal. But yeah, it's awesome. Like, I'm really enjoying the job. And yeah, because I'm working from home, it fits so well around family life as well, because I can log off at 5 o'clock and I'm home. You know, I can be downstairs in 5 seconds and then I'm with family. It's not finish at five, get stopped by customers, so don't actually get out of the building till 5:15, stuck in rush hour traffic, it's an hour drive home, get home, have a quick hi, how are you doing, with the family, and then it's the kids' bedtime, and yeah, it's so much better for everything. All of the bleed and poison effects. What are you? Are you the super stamp? You are. Nice. Progress. Yeah, these traps are cool. So I can trap them with the wolf trap, and then the slicer causes bleeding. But bleeding also causes poison. And yeah, it's just, it's cool. All the while they're trapped as well. I'm probably gonna go now since it's midnight. I have to wake up at 5 a.m. All right, Chris, no worries, man. Well, thank you very much for swinging by. It's a pleasure having you back in the channel. Yeah, we've got a new schedule. The stream is now Tuesday and Thursday at 9 p.m. UK time. Saying that, I probably won't be streaming this Thursday because I'm down in London for work. But I'll see what I can do. But yeah, usually... it's Tuesday and Thursday. Yeah, jump in the Discord as well if you're not already. I can't remember if you are. I was mentioning when you move fast in a roll, it drops frames from time to time. Ooh, oh god, yeah, okay. I don't know if I can change that midstream. No, I can't change that midstream. Okay. Yeah, it's dropped quite a lot. Awesome, Chris. Yeah, it's been a pleasure. I hope you're doing all right. And yeah, I will hopefully chat to you again sometime soon. Yeah, thank you, Slade. It's weird, because last time I streamed this, it was fine. But I haven't changed anything from the last stream, and that was really, really good. The internet's obviously having a bit of a moment tonight. Thank you. guy in the back. Now we're going to keep the one we got. Oh, stop hitting that one. We're gonna go for that, actually. That's quite useful. Okay, I just doubles round. Although, what's down here? Skadoosh. Okay, we need to go back down. Check what's over here. There's a bad guy over here. Wasn't in that. Or just leaving little notes for each other. Bodies piling up endlessly, burning them is no longer good. Some get back up, and others even manage to get their hands on weapons. We have to leave this island while we still can. Did I just get into that? 14:50, nice. I'm sure it's 15 minutes for this one. Oh, there isn't one here. It's 15 minutes for the next room. Definitely isn't gonna happen. Okay, what have we got? 40 exactly. We got, there's two 20s there that we could get. I think we're gonna do that actually. Yeah, we only got one more to get the showroom now. I'm gonna burn that. Damn it. Okay, boss time. How's everyone in chat doing? Thank you for hanging out. It's appreciated. Definitely need to sort out the fundraiser thing. Try and get a better looking way of doing it. the low one. 25, that'll do. Work on unlocking something. Okay, we can't go Slumbering Sanctuary. We haven't got. Yeah, it's the wall climb on that. So we can't do that yet. That's my 30 kills. Got a bit nuts for a second there. Will not grab this one yet. Thank you. let's go this way. No. That's better. All of that is better. How's everyone doing? Welcome to the channel. Thank you one and all for coming and hanging out. It's appreciated. What are you? Yeah. Covers the ground with oil that burns around you. Generates a toxic cloud around the trap. That's all, yeah. 2 minute cooldown though. No, I don't like that actually. I'm not gonna go for that. Thought we might. That's not gonna work for us. Okay, we can't go that way. That was close. That one. Except that was my wolf trap. That was a mistake. That was what held the bosses in place. What is that? Oh, that got painful for a second there. I have no idea where I'm going. That's promising though. That's that. Down there it is. Nope, not down that. That one. There's another clap there. I'm guessing this is going to lead to another key. Maybe not. Fair enough. That way then. There we go. Got a little bit closer to my liking that. Yeah, let's go. 24-26. I think that gets me the next time room. Except it's not there. That'll work. This is all doubling back on that the saw, inflicting bleeding and poison. Like the entire build of our run at the minute. Damage though, just from the traps. Oh, that was it. I didn't attack him at all then. That was just the traps doing it. We're gonna go for that. May I regret it, but we're gonna go for that. And we are not gonna go for that. That was a really good boss fight, actually. That, yeah, that'll work. Done. What have we got? 20. Just keep on this for now. This one, then gold reserves. And then we need to do the, forge. Increase the chance of getting a plus rank item straight off the bat. Certainly be going better. Oh, what? He wasn't facing that way. Shenanigans. All the shenanigans. It's probably my last one for the night, guys. Something with some kind of damage effect. Keep running away from enemies and they're not dead. I'm so used to the like the dot damage just finishing them off. Boom. Burn the ground on the smash attacks. Always a good one. We did hit 30 as well. Nice. Done. Toxic cloud. Hoping for a plus damage to poisoned. Didn't happen. Get out. Take that on. Nope. How's everyone in chat doing? Like I said, it's probably my last one for the night. Thank you everyone who's been here. Thank you Slade for that huge sub bomb as well earlier. Appreciate it. Scared the crap out of me as well, but appreciate it. That's what I get for not remembering my own alerts. Thank you. There he is. Can't go that way. Can't go that way. Let's go back and grab that schematic first. It wasn't a schematic, it was a grenade. Still useful. Better than the one we had. We got a minute and 10 to get to the exit. Okay, that's not too bad. There it is. Yep, just a straight upgrade. Get gold as well as the sun. And the gold for selling it. Done. Damn it. That one. I think I just jumped under that platform then. Oh, that's quite nice. Obviously completely intentional as well. Let's keep going red. Get out. Oh. settle on which way we want to look. That'd be ace. Just not worth it. I was going to. There we go. And up top, yeah, there is. Off. Don't want your grenades. What are you? Well, you could not. That would work too. Okay, almost done. Nope. That one do. If enemies bleed and drop a healing item. Oh, actually. Not too bad. Yeah, right. I've got like no dots on this setup. Kind of annoying. Oh, I'm not paying attention. More shields, that's tempting. Nearby enemies take 50% damage as well, and ignore shields and drops a toxic cloud. We're gonna go with that. We're gonna go with that. Take the money and run. I'll work. Put a cloud around the trap. Done. Going for this one because of the 10 grand when we reset. Pretty useful. I can't get up there. Chain damage that really does it for this weapon. Hmm. No. Makes the victim bleed. Generates toxic cloud around the trap. We're not going to take that. We're going to stick with the poison. Everything else synergizes really well with the poison. Stick with that. I'll start throwing something else in the mix. Seems exactly the same. But we get 2 grand for burning it. Phone on the floor. Ow. Oh no, damn it. Yep, thank you. Oh, that just all of the suck. That did not go well. give this boot a quick go. Pretty cool if you're against the wall. Yeah, I'm not sold on it, to be honest. Nice. What next? Frenzy? This is really slow. Yeah, the sword's really slow. Alright, we're just kind of speed running this one. Not worrying too much about this run. Having some fun with the boot. There we go. What do we go for? Frenzy. Almost definitely gonna die here. But I think the spider climb rune is around here somewhere. We do have to take out the next boss. Except very unlikely we're gonna get it. We are not even remotely built for actually making progress. That's better. You have something shiny. You have those. Do that. Oh, there's some stuff. Okay, can't go. Do anything there. Is.
bowls.
Stop doing that. I'm drunk to my piss. That boss HP there, yeah, I just didn't have anything that like damaged over time. I mean, I completely speed ran that. We didn't have any kind of build whatsoever to actually make any progress. But that's the route we need to take to get the spider climb rune. So that is what we'll be doing next run. But for now, I'm gonna head out. Yeah, it's been fun. I need to get to bed. Like I say, I don't know if there'll be a stream on Thursday this week. I'm down in London again. I might just try and do an IRL stream from my phone in the hotel room. Just do like a half hour of chatting to you guys. I'll try and do something. But yeah, there won't be gaming. Slade, thank you so much for the kindness earlier. Thank you for that gift sub, Bomb. Thank you for the host. Thank you for getting hyped about Dare Jar and all that kind of fun stuff. It's massively appreciated, honestly. Everyone else who was here, Crisp, Duns, Akira. Thank you to all the lurkers. Lots of people now subbed to the channel just through lurking, which is awesome. Yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Like I say, I'll be back. I'll try and do something on Thursday, even if it's just me sat in my bed, in my hotel room, chatting to you guys for a bit. But yeah, the fundraiser's going, the Dare Jar's going, let's get this thing rolling. I'll make this a thing on your server. This is my goal as a mod of this channel to the Disco Inferno. Hey, if it's a dare, we need to raise the money. I'm not doing any of the dares until we hit the money. So, you know, that's where it's at. And again, this isn't money that's coming to me. This is fundraising money. This is for the charity. Whether you sub to the channel, you know, 50% of all the subs, well, all the subs, all the bits, they all go into the pot. When we get a payout, half of that goes to special effect. The more subs we have, the more bits that get cheered, the quicker we get a payout, the bigger that payout is, the more money I can give to special effect. If you want to donate and just throw £5 at the fundraiser, go to the link. The link's always available there. There's a special effect button under the tree. Click on that, drop a fiver, drop a tenner, drop 50 quid. Whatever you can afford. The sooner we hit those payouts, the faster we can do the stuff. That's where it is. Oh yeah, let me put that there. In fact, whilst I'm thinking about it, that there as well. Transform into vertical. I mean, this probably won't be there next stream because it will be, the window won't be open or something. But yeah, it's there. I'm going to sort out the list of fundraising, donation, incentives, and all that kind of fun stuff over the next few days. Get those public. You guys will be able to see it. But yeah, we need to get that number up. That's where it's at. I'm going to head out. Take care, everyone. All the love, all the hugs. I'll catch you guys later.